We want to multiply the given complex numbers. To do this, we'll multiply them algebraically like we normally would when multiplying binomials. But then we need to make sure the product is in the form of a complex number, or in the form a plus or minus bi, where a is a real number, and plus or minus bi is an imaginary number with I equal to the square root of negative 1. So to find the product of 7 plus 5i and 2 plus 3i, just as when multiplying binomials, we'll have four products. We'll have 1, 2, 3, 4. So 7 times 2 is equal to 14. 7 times 3i is equal to 21i, so plus 21i. Then we have 5i times 2, that's going to be plus 10i. And then we have 5i times 3i, that'll be plus 15i squared. Now we need to simplify this. Notice how the two middle terms are imaginary numbers, so we can add these two like we add like terms. So we'd have 14, this would be plus 31i, plus 15i squared. But we're still not done, because remember, a complex number must fit this form, so we need to simplify this I squared. And since I squared is equal to negative 1, we can replace I squared with negative 1. So we'd have 14 plus 31i plus 15 times negative 1. Well, 15 times negative 1 is negative 15. And now we can add negative 15 and 14, which would be negative 1. So our final product will be negative 1 plus 31i. When we give our final complex number, we should put the real part first and the imaginary part second. Next we have 6 minus 3i squared. And there are no shortcuts here. We're going to have 6 minus 3i times 6 minus 3i. And again, we're going to have four products, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So 6 times 6 is 36. 6 times negative 3i is going to be negative 18i. And negative 3i times 6 is also negative 18i. Then we have negative 3i times negative 3i. That's going to be positive 9i squared. And now again, we need to simplify. The two middle terms are like terms, or imaginary numbers, which we can combine. And then we need to substitute negative 1 for I squared. So we'd have 36. This is going to be minus 36i. And then here we'll have plus 9 times negative 1. Well, 9 times negative 1 is equal to negative 9. So now we can add 36 and negative 9, which would give us 27. So our final product would be 27 minus 36i. Let's go ahead and verify these on the graphing calculator. We need to make sure we're in complex mode, so we'll press the mode key, make sure we have a plus bi highlighted. Once we do, we can go back to the home screen and just type in our products. So we first have 7 plus 5i. The I is second decimal point, times 2 plus 3i. This verifies our first product. And then we have 6 minus 3i squared. We can press this button here for squared, which verifies our second product as well. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.